listening. Before we start tonight, I want to acknowledge the seniors in the jazz band. We have on drum set Luke Blecker. On saxophone, Andrew Savino. Trumpet section, we got Luke Weber. And in the rhythm section, we've got on the bass and guitar, Mr. Matt Patone, senior. And back there on the keyboard, we've got Jesse Klein. And as you might have guessed, I am stalling for time right now as the bite piper in my band comes running up. He's not a senior, but he'll be wearing a kilt. You'll see him when he comes running in any moment from now. Welcome, we are the GL Jazz Ensemble, and we're playing four great tunes tonight. The first one is called Scrapple from the Apple by Charlie Parker and arranged by Dick Hughes. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to do something we haven't done yet and take the jazz group back to its sort of cradle of birth of jazz, New Orleans jazz, which is formerly called Dixieland. These days it's called New Orleans, to being politically correct. It features more of the clarinets and some of the woodwinds in a different capacity, and this one is called Royal Garden Blues. Thank you. A contemporary of that piece is the next piece, but from a different genre, as it were. In that time period, jazz was growing to be popular, and by the swing period of the 30s and 40s, it was indeed popular. But at the same time, as you would imagine, the jazz sound affected popular music. Singer-songwriters would take that style and put it in. The next tune is not quite a jazz tune per se, but it is a pop song in the jazz style. It's a great old tune, and it's not very well known. It's called Good Night, Sweetheart. All right, next up, thank you very much. Next up, we have a tune that's not jazz whatsoever. Since rock and roll stole from jazz, we figured we should steal it back. So let's end the night with Vehicle. It's a not well-known tune, except for car commercials. You hear it very often on Chevy commercials. Vehicle by the Ides of March. Enjoy. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. You've been a great audience.
All right. So we have our steel pan ensemble, a world percussion ensemble. I'm excited to present to you guys today. We're going to do a piece, Una Paloma Blanca, a Spanish piece in the Caribbean style composed by a Dutchman. And then we're going to do a little Rude by the rock band Magic. And then travel to the Far East and do, with our full percussion ensemble, Sketches of the Orient. Okay, Josh, take it away.
Thank you.
We have a special surprise for you. We weren't planning on having any small groups play tonight, but one group begged me. I kid you not. I'm not joking. They'll tell you it's true to play Bach. And last year we played some Irish tunes. They're like, we like this, but we want to play Bach. And it's incomprehensible to me that a student or any group of students would be desperate to play Bach. I didn't like Bach until I reached the age of maturity, which was somewhere in the 20s, I don't know when. And suddenly, I liked Bach, but these folks like Bach now, and they begged us to play it, and we have an addition. We do have a couple seniors that were the spearheads behind this. Raise your hand. We have Taylor, Julia, Raymond, and Sarah Azzalone, and we'll do a Bach organ prelude and fugue for you before intermission. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Exceptionally difficult piece, and yes, there is band candy in the lobby, so feel free to buy some. But first, before we do that, one more round for the saxophones, especially the seniors. Bravo. Thank you. We'll see you in the second half.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. fun piece. Next piece. We have the pleasure of having this semester a fantastic student teacher with us. He's been here since March, and prior to that, he worked at Mount Park Elementary School. His name is Mr. Connor Coffey. He's from Kane. He's graduating on Thursday, and then actually he was just accepted into the 78th Army Band, so that's a great honor for him. It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Coffey for the next selection.
Thank you.
In addition to Mr. Coffey, I want to take a moment to acknowledge my colleagues here. We have, of course, Mr. Colinari with the percussion, who's helping out with the band in the back right now with the percussion section. We have Mr. Beam, a teacher emeritus from Woodruff School. Welcome back. Good to see you here. And yeah, go ahead. I have my colleagues here, Mrs. Connolly, and the other department staff. Thank you for your assistance. We have student helpers behind stage helping us out. We have Marcela Martinez, Serena Shen, and Maya Sternberg, and the myriad of percussionists moving things back and forth. Thank you to you. Thank you to the custodians. Thank you to the TV light and sound crew who help plan all this great stuff. Yes, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. And thank you as well to, we have teachers and administrators here tonight. We have Mrs. Lori Scott, supervisor of music. We have Mrs. Ratner here, superintendent of schools. We also have tonight with us the present principal, Mr. Scott McKinney, and the incoming principal, how about that, two for the price of one, Mr. Robert Nixon for next year. Welcome back. And then we have two board members here, Mrs. Jean Parker and Mr. Bill Cassano. So thank you for being here and for all your support of the Department of Music. So as you can tell, that was Yee Banks and Blaise of Bonnie Doon, a Percy Aldridge Granger arrangement. We've entered Scotland now, and the next piece is also Scottish. While the percussionists are shimmying back to the stage, let me give you some background on this next piece. It's one of my favorite band pieces ever, I have to say, one. Two, I'm not sure where the accent came from, but I'll go with it. Two, it wasn't even Scottish of anything. It's based off the Jacobite uprising of 1746, I do believe it was. And what happened was This piece is a mixture of original music, meaning from 1746, and new original music from 2000. And it's mixing these themes together. The bagpipes played some of these themes at the start of this concert. You'll hear some of them again. And the idea of the piece is trying to create the Battle of Culloden, which was the final battle of the Jacobite uprising. And it's a monumentous work. It's a great work. Julie Jira wrote it, and she's one of my favorites. She happened to help score The Karate Kid. Little known fact, and she has chosen her life now to writing for band music, specifically for high school and college bands. This is a really fun, challenging work. We've been working extremely hard on it, and yeah, enjoy Culloden Movement 3 of Julie Jiro. Oh, one more thing. I'm absent-minded today, apparently. We do want to acknowledge students as well. First, let's acknowledge the kids that went to Scotland, because they were actually within 3 miles of the battlefield of Culloden. Go, stand up. You went to Scotland, stand up. How about that? Thank you. There we go. Percussionists in the back are waving. And then, not to miss a really important event coming up in less than a month, I wanted to have the seniors please stand, or percussionists, raise your hands and give us a nice wave, because you're standing already. Seniors, please, stand up. 18 of them graduating on June 18th. I want to thank the seniors for a great 4 years, and it's been my pleasure to work with them and everyone else that will one day graduate from this fine school. Culloden 3. Thank you. And I want to thank all my students. That piece, I didn't tell them how hard it was, except I did every single day, but I didn't. It's one of those things where you tell them, is this kind of tough and it's not so. Yeah, they did a great job, and I'm so proud of them all. Really pushed us, and I want to wish you all a great night. Seniors will miss you. Thank you very much, all of you. It's been my pleasure, and safe trip home. Thank you.